Today in this video, we are going to learn how to make a single phase submersible pump starter. So friends, let's start the video. Friends, the submersible pump we have, to turn on and off this pump, I am using a contactor. Besides, the motor we have, for protection of motor, we need to use overload relay. I am not using overload relay here, I am using this MCB in place of relay. MCB will also provide the protection, same as overload relay. After this, to turn on and off the contactor, we use start push button and stop push button. So whatever the motor we have, to turn on the motor, first we will do the power wiring. For power wiring, what I will do is, the terminal box here, to the first and second number terminal of terminal box, we will connect phase supply and neutral supply. Let us assume that this one number terminal here, with this terminal, we will connect neutral power supply. So take a wire and connect this wire with neutral point of MCB. You can see here N is written. So with this terminal, I connected neutral supply wire. Now take the other end of wire and with neutral terminal here, connect this wire. So I am connecting the wire here in this way. After this, at second terminal, we have to connect phase supply. So what I will do is, take a small piece of wire and to this MCB here, we will provide the phase supply through this terminal. Now in this MCB, the output terminal here, at the phase supply terminal of this output terminal, with this point, connect a wire. Now the other end of wire, take this end and with the power terminal here, among all these terminals, with the first terminal you have to connect this wire. So I connected this wire also. After this, at the output terminal of this MCB, where we get neutral power supply, connect a wire with this terminal. And take the other end of wire to the power terminals of contactor, connect this wire with this terminal. Now when contactor is turned on and you will get the output power supply, connect this output supply with the terminal box. For this, connect one end of wire with the terminal of contactor where we connected phase supply. At the same output terminal, connect this wire. Now take other end of the wire and with the terminal box here, connect this wire with one terminal of terminal box. So I connected the wire here. In this contactor, at this terminal, we connected neutral supply before. Now with the output terminal of same terminal, connect a wire with this terminal. Now take other end of the wire, the phase supply we connected here, just leave one terminal and with the second one, connect this wire. So I connected the wire here. As you can see. Friends, the submersible pump we have, from this submersible pump, three wires are coming out for connection. First is for running winding, second wire is for starting winding and third one is for common terminal. So the three wires which are coming from motor, among these three, the running winding, which is of red color, bring the wire and with the phase supply here from contactor, connect the wire here. After this, the blue color wire from motor is going to be connected at this third number terminal. This means neutral supply is to be connected with common wire. After this, the yellow wire of motor is to be connected at this middle terminal here. So at this terminal, phase supply is connected and at this terminal, neutral supply is connected. Now at this middle point, which supply is going to be connected? Friends, at this middle terminal here, power supply through capacitor must be connected. So we will learn the connection of capacitor in control wiring. For now, what I will do is, at this empty middle terminal here, connect a wire. And the power supply at this point will come from this terminal of the contactor. So I connected the wire here. To turn on the submersible pump, I am using two capacitors. In some of the submersible pump, you will find only one capacitor. In some of the pump, you will find two also. These two capacitors which are used have different values. Like in this capacitor, the value of this capacitor is 36 microfarad and this one is of 120 microfarad. This means this capacitor here will be called as running capacitor and this capacitor here will be called as starting capacitor. This means the use of this capacitor is only to start the motor. Here I created a space to mount these. So I am mounting both the capacitors here. Now in this starting capacitor, you will find two wires. And in the running capacitor also, you will find two wires. What you have to do is, From the starting and running capacitor, take one wire, so I took one wire from both. Now I will connect both the wires together. After connecting both the wires, in the contactor here, at this terminal in this contactor, connect this wire with this terminal. Friends, the submersible pump you have, if the rating of submersible pump is below 0.5 HP, then in this condition, you have to use only running capacitor. Use of this other capacitor is not required. We use this other capacitor so that at heavy loads also, motor starts by itself. We will do the connection of this other capacitor in such a way that when we press start push button to turn on the motor, at that time only this capacitor will work. And when we release this, then power supply through this capacitor will stop. So the input wire of this capacitor here, this wire is to be connected in control wiring. The control wiring which is going to be performed, in this what we will do, in this MCB the phase supply wire at the output, with this wire connect another wire. Now take other end of this wire and to this stop push button, the element present in this push button, this is the element of the stop push button. So with this element we will connect this wire. So I am connecting this wire here. Now of this same contact at the output terminal, connect another wire with this terminal. Take other end of the wire and in this start push button here, the element of start push button which is present here, you have to connect the wire with this element. Be careful that the start push button you have at the back side of this, you have to use two NO contact. Why two NO contacts are used, you will understand later. Take the wire which is coming from stop push button and connect with the element of start push button. Now the point at which we connected wire, with the same point connect another wire and take the other end of wire and to this another NO contact, with this contact connect this wire. This NO contact here to which power supply is coming from stop push button, with this contact connect a wire. Take the other end of wire and to this contactor, at the coil of this contactor at A1 terminal, like you can see here is A1 terminal. So with this terminal connect this wire. Now to operate this contactor, we also have to provide neutral power supply. So what we will do is, in this MCB at neutral terminal, with this terminal connect one wire. Take other end of the wire and with the A2 terminal of contactor, connect the wire with this terminal, in this way. Now this starting capacitor we have, second wire of this capacitor is left for connection. So take this wire and after this, what we will do is, the second NO contact here, which is of start push button, you can see this is start push button and at the back side two contacts are connected. Through one contact power is supplied to turn on the contactor and through second contact power is supplied to this capacitor. So take this wire and with this terminal here connect this wire. Power supply to starting capacitor is supplied from output terminal of start push button because when we press start push button then power is supplied from here and goes through this capacitor. And to the motor we have, to the starting winding of the motor, power is supplied. But the moment at which we release start push button, then power supply will not flow in this capacitor. This is why to this capacitor, power is supplied through this push button. Now, to hold this contactor, what we will do is, the start push button we have, at the input terminal of this start push button, connect one more wire here. Take the other end of wire and the contactor you have, you can see here is NO contact. With this contact, you have to connect this wire. Now with the output terminal of this NO contact, connect a wire. And take the other end of this wire to the A1 terminal here, with this terminal, connect this wire. In this way, you have to do the connections. Now the terminal box you have, in this terminal box, to this first and second number terminal, we have to provide incoming power supply. So I am connecting incoming power supply here. After this, to explain the working of this starter, I am connecting a fan here. Take the wires of the fan and to these output terminals here, connect the wires in this way. Although all the three wires of submersible pump you have How to connect these wires, I already told you. In the same way, you have to do the connections. Now I am turning on the MCB. After turning on the MCB, this start push button here, press this button. You can see motor is turned on. If I want to stop this motor, then press this stop push button. Motor will turn off. Friends, understand a concept here. To the submersible pump we have, through this starting capacitor, power must be supplied in starting. For this, what we have to do is press this start push button for at least 2 seconds and then release it. Till the time you press start push button, at that time, through this starting capacitor, power will be supplied to the starting winding of motor. When you release this button, power supply will be stopped through this starting capacitor. When motor is started, then in this condition, motor will work only on running capacitor. Starting capacitor got bypassed. Now if you want to stop this, simply press stop push button, motor will go off. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, give like on my video. If you are new to the channel, subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching this video.